225. Look alive, baby.
It's episode 225, CWTFB.
It's CWTFB Radio, man.
You know where we at.
You know where we at, man. We at the Garage Media Center, man.
You got Mix Force, DJ?
We gonna get y'all started off, man. A little smooth like, you heard?
Hey, yo, fuck YouTube, you heard?
Why fuck YouTube?
Because they not about to let this play.
We in the Garage Media Center at the Sound Lab. Getting y'all started off right. Episode 225. Okay. If you feeling all right, let me hear you say, ow, ow. What's thicker than your average podcast, nigga?
Niggas don't think shit, stink pink gators. My Detroit players, Tim's for my hooligans
in Brooklyn.
Dead right, hit the head right.
Just be there at night.
Never been school since days of under rules. Never lose, never choose to.
And once again, we back at you with another one. Another week
to us, one screw us. Hold on,
was
yeah, Papa Ed, you better.
We gonna bring it back,
cause that was by force.
Puffy need to listen to this after the laughter. Come tears, motherfucker. Repent, nigga. Call TD Jakes, nigga. Come on, let's go.
Try and get the vibe out of y'all, man. Oh my God.
First thing, it's for the niggas that's about to get robbed this summer.
With your arms straight up, nigga.
It's for all the niggas.
Your arms straight up.
They baby moms this summer. Bring it back. I'm rewind. Let's go. Come on. DJ Machine in the building. We're gonna bring it back. It's for my niggas about to get married.
Hey now. Hey.
My niggas about to get married.
I choose you, baby.
And we choose what the future brings, nigga.
You understand me?
Uh-huh.
I choose.
Uh-huh. What you know about this, man? You was on that? You was on this?
You ain't on this.
Yeah.
What do you think?
Hey, come on.
You see, niggas don't make begging music like this no more, man.
You always gotta take something great like this.
Go ahead, flip it, my lady. Ain't no wrong with a flip now. Oh, ain't no wrong with a flip.
My bitch is choosy. Look, I never fuck without a rubber. Never in the seats like it under the cover. Money on the dresser. Drive a compressor. Top notch hold, get the most, not the lesser. Trash like the fuck for $40 in the club. Fucking up the game, bitch, she gets no love. She be cross country, give it all that she got. A thousand a pop for the billions off the lot. I smashed up the gray one, bought me a red.
Options, nigga. Options. How many motherfuckers got options?
You ain't a pimp, you a baron.
Hey. Hey.
I choose you, baby.
Pay attention to who she's choosing on, nigga. Relax. What I'm saying,
a lot of niggas won't understand.
A lot of niggas won't understand the pain.
A lot of niggas, shit, niggas just don't get.
That's why you gotta bring them back.
Like pussy, and respect, nigga.
This is for all the niggas getting they koofy smacked. Some of.
I hope you niggas are victim to armed robbery on that dog.
Oh, the knee, man. Alright, we're getting cooking. We're about to get going. Episode 225. I am Charlie Machine. This is my right hand man, Cash. No motherfucking sense.
Zero.
In the garage. Come on. Ever clean it on your zenith. Come on. We're in the garage. SoundLab, ma.com, book your sessions. And you offer any, mine, take off your panties. Hey, I said, Boston, I got lost in Boston.
Boston,
of course, Miami. Come on, man. Let's go. You think that?
Wow.
Yeah, yeah.
Good mix.
Come on, shout out to my man, Killer Cam, over there pissing white people off on CNN.
It is what it is, right?
It is what it is. And it ain't what it ain't, nigga.
That dog.
God damn. CWTFB Radio, man. You make the fuck out of me. You're in the garage media center, man. How you feeling, my brother?
I'm feeling good, man.
I'm glad, man. Per I'm glad,
usual.
Man.
Per usual, man.
How was your last 7 days, man?
Well, I've been chilling.
Yeah.
NBA.
Just gambling.
I'm chilling. Yeah. I'm wedding preparing, really, man. Like, yeah. I hate that a lot of niggas feel like they can't take enjoyment out of their wedding. Like, it's yours too, my nigga.
It's for your wife.
Yeah. No, well, yeah.
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 Yeah. Calm down.
It is.
You just got to show up and pay.
Yeah, but nah, but I get to have fun too, though, Chiz.
Oh, no. The fun is going to be there. Here's the thing.
Yeah.
We as men, we create our own fun.
Yeah.
Women, they do the pleasantries. They like the shit. You know what I mean? Yeah, it's like they want to make everybody else have fun. Motherfuckers that they don't even fucking like, my nigga. Yeah. You understand me?
But me too, though. But either way, I'm having fun through it out, like all the planning and all that shit. So I've been doing a lot of that. That's been a lot of my 7 days.
That's what's up, man.
NBA. How about you?
My 7 days has been frustrating, man.
Really?
I mean, because, you know, I hired an editor last week.
Oh.
And to say the least, the editor just didn't do what the editor needed to do.
Oh, hold on. You can't go online to do this. You can't do this part.
Why?
Because you hired the editor.
Well, first off, the editor volunteered. Okay. And then I said, okay. Let's see what you got.
About this shit on the editor right now?
The editor ain't got shit. Just saying, nigga.
Just like that?
Just like that. Guy, man. Yeah.
Damn.
But that was my frustration for the week. And you know, it's the end of the business. I'm the end of the month, man. I'm in the car business. My nigga, it's always crazy. So, you know, shit like that. You know, just trying to get these white niggas off my back. Yeah. You know what I mean? And shit like that. Meet my quotas, nigga. But we here, man. We here. And,
yeah.
You know, it's my favorite part of the week, man.
Fact that, though.
It always is.
Oh, yo, I did want to talk about some shit. You want to talk about some shit that happened? Yo, you seen that? What's the name of the white boy that, these cops are not killing white people enough. Like, I feel like they kill niggas a lot, but they don't kill white people enough. Like, you know what I mean?
You talking about the white boy at the movie theater?
At the movie theater. Yeah, like, you know what I mean?
Yeah,
like,
I don't remember his name.
He should got the shirt shot off of him. Like, you know what I mean? Like, what the fuck is this?
Yeah, I don't remember.
Like, niggas don't get, they don't get shot enough.
I don't understand how
they
the
shoot us so quick.
How did the cops get there?
If I'm a cop and as soon as I get there, it's reported that there's a nigga in there stabbing motherfuckers.
Kids.
Stabbing kids. Already got this report as I'm driving up. Nigga, I'm getting ready. I've been at the gun range.
I'm
getting ready to shoot. I want to kill this nigga.
Yeah.
No. This nigga got wheeled off in the ambulance with the shit propped up.
Yeah.
Like, yo, you comfortable, sir? Like, we about to go to Chili's. You want some Chili's?
Yeah. I mean, honestly.
Like, yo, I just don't like that shit. I don't like that these niggas be surviving after doing this traumatic ass shit. Like, they usually smoke themselves.
Yeah, what was he gonna do? Stab himself in the movie theater?
Yeah, stab himself to death.
I don't think niggas do shit like that. Niggas
do. They don't.
What the fuck is this, Japan, nigga?
I mean, the girls survived, thank God.
Yeah, the girls were good.
The girls
non-life-threatening shit.
And they were all siblings. It's crazy.
Yeah. Now, What was the nationality or ethnicity of the victims?
Socks on?
Everybody was white.
Everybody was
white. So he just didn't give a fuck.
Yeah, he didn't give a fuck.
So it wasn't even
It like wasn't even racial. It was just old.
So he was just like, I'm stabbing something.
Yeah, but I just thought, you know what? No bullshit. I bring my daughters to the movies because in the daylight, because it's like, it's cheaper. You know what I'm saying? And it's like, I would do it. You know what I mean? So like, I would be
you
would
so. Do what?
I would bring my daughters to the theaters in the daytime. So as I do that, I would be so upset to hear that a nigga was in there stabbing little girls. Because honestly, I would be watching that movie and I would be so excited to hear it while I was in that movie theater.
Right, right.
Because I would then use all 10 bullets that I have in my handgun
right.
to murder this nigga. You know what I mean?
Well, are you even supposed to go into the movies with your gun on you?
It doesn't even matter. I would, to protect my children, to protect everybody, I'm going to do so. You know what I mean? So, like, I would have all enjoyment on making sure I don't miss. That would be my main, like, hit this nigga everything above the lower legs. Like, please, like, what? Like, these cops is crazy. Like, these cops is crazy.
I don't even know if Massachusetts is a state for that, man. You fuck around, go to jail.
Either way.
Even if you protecting everybody in the theater.
Either way, I think that the way that they let the fucking white people get off with these crimes.
Right.
It's sending a message, my nigga. It's like, yo, bro, you're going to be fine. Don't kill yourself. You could kill all those people. It's cool.
when you get out,
yeah.
You got time.
It's going to be fine. You sending a message, nigga.
What was the charges against him, do you know?
Not yet.
They had to give him some charges.
Well, yeah, I mean, what the fuck is it? Like a fucking attempted murder one?
Some shit. I don't know, bro.
It has to be like the girls didn't die. So either way, like,
yeah.
But he's gonna get out.
Damn. And he's white. Is he Jewish?
What's about your man?
Who's my man?
You know who's your man.
Big T?
Yeah.
Free Big T, man. Come on, man. Trump 2024, man. Look, he didn't do that shit.
Nah, he paid the bitch.
He ain't do nothing.
Come on, Chiz.
He ain't do that shit. You know he ain't do that shit.
He paid the girl. Can you say it?
All right, he might have paid the bitch.
He paid the bitch.
All right, so look. Okay, all right.
All right.
The first president to pay somebody off. Nigga.
No, he's not.
They just tried to make an example out of this nigga.
They tried to burn him.
And this is what's gonna. This is the funny thing, right?
They tried to burn
him. Everybody found out today in America that you can run for president with felonies, nigga.
Yeah.
And they cannot tell you to drop out of the race, because guess what? For that charge, he's not going to jail.
No, he's not.
It was a civil case, right?
Yeah.
So what?
I don't understand why you saying free him.
Nah, I'm just saying free Big T, because, you know, I mean, free him out the you know. You know what I'm saying?
Stop
like, you know
it, shit. Like, this niggas you know in the you know. Because
niggas is, they trying to keep my man down. You know what I'm saying?
Stop
like, you know
it,
mean?
Bro. Can you
like,
stop that?
You ain't
that?
Seen Chef G with him? Come on, man. You don't like Chef
about
G?
That?
You don't like Chef
about
G?
That? Yo, so Chef G. Let's talk about it, bro. So this nigga trying to ban him from Summer Jam.
Peter Rosenberg.
You said the name.
Peter Rosenberg says that Chef G and Sleepy Hollow should be banned from Summer Jam because they were at a Trump support rally. Okay, nigga.
No Jew could ever ban anybody from
anything. Now, here's the thing. You see, I'm not going to say what kind of person this was.
You said his last name.
Yeah, Rosenberg gives it away, right? Yeah, fact. But he was a Jew, right?
That nigga said, you're banned, nigga.
Now, my thing is just more like,
what's up? How you feel about it?
So can people not have political views?
Well, here it
goes. Or can they not align themselves politically? For self-gain? Isn't that what politics is all about?
Before we proceed, would you say the same thing about religion, nigga?
Yeah. Right. Doesn't mean I'm not going to make fun of it, nigga.
I know. I'm just saying. All right, we can agree. Yeah. You can say the same thing about religion. All right, therefore, nigga, you got to be... Yeah, you could do that. You could do that for a gain, absolutely. But you got to deal with the fucking circumstances, nigga. And them circumstances come different. These are niggas that don't listen to hip-hop. These are now
Peter Rosenberg has to listen to
Well, not, I mean, Peter Rosenberg, yeah, yeah, but not all the Rosenbergs.
Yeah, David Rosenberg. Yeah. Shout out to David. That's my
all
guy.
All the Steven Rosenbergs, all the Jeff Rosenbergs, all the Joe Rosenbergs.
I know a Peter Rosenberg that's not that Peter Rosenberg. You know
all right,
what I mean?
All right then.
Shout
nigga,
out to Pete. That's my
you
guy.
You understand me that? Then, nigga. Yeah. So them niggas don't listen to Chef G. You know what I mean? They looking for that real nigga's real name. You know what
yeah,
mean?
Well, I mean, think about it like this, man. I mean, you can't ban a nigga from a show every time he does some shit that you don't like.
Nah, no Jew could ban anything from hip-hop. Not from hip-hop.
I mean, I don't know, man. Who owns iHeartRadio?
A Jew.
Right.
YouTube.
Right.
A Jew.
You're right. So, again.
The list goes on.
There's the argument.
But I mean, hey, man.
I think Rosenberg is just, you know, he's upset about the whole Trump shit. I don't even understand why niggas are so mad about Trump. You saw what what the nigga Biden said the other day.
He mad at Jews too? Trump is mad at Jews? He hate the Jews?
Nah. He never said shit about Jews.
He never said
But that. What I would say is, Biden, he goes, he was talking about Trump, talking about like, yeah, he was trying to arrest, you know, all the white people or some shit. Like it was crazy.
Yeah. But I didn't think he black for real.
Biden, yo, and the black people be eating it up.
What, yo, did he go on a breakfast club? What he say?
If you don't vote for me, then you ain't black. If you have to make a decision on if you vote for me for Donald Trump, then you ain't black.
Damn.
And niggas ate that shit up.
Niggas ate that shit up for real.
Hey, man. All right, let's not get too political, man.
I laugh at that shit all the time.
Let's not get too political, man. Shout out to Trump, Biden, RIP. I know you ain't dead, but we know it's coming. You know what I'm saying?
Trump is a little fucked up, too.
All right, man. So let's talk about these ratings that we got this week, man. Red Cups of ratings, just like every other week. We got two projects that we're going to rate. This week,
this
honestly,
a joyful
man.
Joyful week, man.
This is like the weakest consistency.
It's my type of hip hop.
Motherfuckers who actually like really go ham with consistently dropping projects and keeping their names alive within their fan bases, man. This week, we're going to start off with my man Bugsy H. He dropped Probato 3. This is Bugsy H. Everything is produced by Maestro Z. This is about 6 records long, 19 minutes. What you think?
Cohesive as fuck.
Yeah, cohesion was crazy.
Cohesion was crazy. Like, it was more like, I don't know, man. Like, this is the sound that I love. Like, this is how, that's how I intake hip hop. Like, boom bap. Like, it's raw.
Do you think niggas hate the boom bap tag? Like, when you call them boom bap rappers?
I hope not.
I know niggas like, that don't matter. Anyway, keep going.
If they do, it would be like, because they want to be like, new age, they want to switch it up. They don't want to be out. They want to be like outdated,
right?
You know what I'm saying?
Because boom bap sounds old.
It does.
Like the term, you know what I mean? But like, I don't think for me it don't. But for some people, some listeners,
I hear that.
Some viewers, they would say, "Oh, boom bap, I want to hear that shit." Or they'll call it drumless.
Drumless. That's crazy.
Or they'll call it some
other
shit. You heard
drumless before?
Yeah, there's a lot of drumless boom bap beats.
Not these.
Bugsy got an ear.
Yeah, like,
he got an ear.
I mean,
for
like I don't know what you want me to say about this shit. Like, I mean, like I enjoyed this shit.
Yeah.
Like,
what was your favorite record?
I don't have one.
Mm-hmm.
I'm lying, but go ahead.
Favorite record had to be "Window Washer's Belt Can't Keep You From Falling." Right. That's featuring his son. That's his son. That kid that was on it, that was his son, man. Consugo, right?
What the fuck is you talking about?
Yeah, man. And I thought, Bugsy's so, like musically creative. Like, you can tell, like, he's a student of the game, man. Like, he really gives a fuck about hip-hop. And not only because his son was on it, but just the subject matter, man. Like, what he was talking about. And, you know, his relationship with his lady and shit like that.
Lonely in the House of Sticks is my shit.
Yeah,
the opening track.
Though. Yeah, the opening track was like, all right, this is setting the tone. This is setting the tone for it. You know,
it's a good part.
It was good. It was a good intro to like grab your attention, but like he just kept that shit going the whole way, man. Ghost of Christmas Past was fire too.
I don't know what it is, man. I'm trying to find out what it is about Bugsy that's lacking.
As far as what?
Like, what is it that don't, you know what I mean? Because it's the sound we like.
I think with Bugsy, there's, you know, I think his style is his style. Like, I think he's mastered his sound. Like, his style.
I never want him to change his style.
That's what I'm saying. Like, I can't tell him what to change about his style because I like him in his element, bro. Like, he's in his pocket. A lot of people won't like this shit, bro. And I know that. And I know that. I know some niggas that turn this shit on. I'm like, man, get this shit the fuck off.
Yeah, nigga. But what the fuck are you listening
like,
to?
Right.
I know. I'm like, yo, but you,
But, you know what I mean?
You know, honestly, with this one, I know last time we were saying he do a lot of hamster wear.
Yeah.
With this one, I felt more bars.
Yeah. Yeah. I felt he sharpened his pen on this one, man.
I feel like
he went off on this one. And not only that, man, that's crazy. The last
record took the clip from the last rating.
And it goes to show you, you know.
Impact.
on impact and on influence, my nigga. On niggas out here. I don't want to toot my own horn and shit, nigga. But we here.
That dog.
But yeah, man, anything else you want to say about this?
Bugsy, man, keep doing your thing.
Yeah.
Please.
Bugsy bro. H.
Yo, you
shout
mad.
Out to Maestro.
You hella crucial, gang.
On dogs.
Hella like, crucial.
This Sam, I'm surprised. No bullshit, I'm surprised. Him and like Body Rock ain't make a record before. Or like, he got a term record. He got a song with term.
Yeah.
I can hear that. But I want to see Bugsy like branch out and actually, you know, talk to a few more people who are doing things that are kind of cohesive.
Yeah, maybe that's to what Sam. It is. Maybe you that's know? What it is.
Like,
maybe
you know, like just branch out and,
branch out.
You know, talk to people that, you know, do records with people that you haven't been used to doing. Because he keeps his circle real close in there as far as the people that he likes to collaborate with and things of that nature, man. But I'd like to see him just step out of that domain.
I feel like sometimes that hinders on your sound. Because like
it might keep you in a pocket
because you're not ready to like if you're not ready to like battle
right
not even if it's not battle but if you're not ready to step into a fucking place where somebody else got skills like you
or right
you don't know what the skills may be like you know what I mean then I feel like you hold
you're changing yourself man.
Just
you know what I mean just branch out a little bit more bro keep doing your thing though man we love your music man so. We're going to talk about Bravado 3 out of 5 red cups. We gave this one a solid 4.3 out of 5, man. Shout out my man Bugsy H. Shout out Maestro Z. Yo, keep raising them babies, man. You know what I mean? I was dope having your son on that album, man. That's dope. Keep doing your thing, brother.
Yeah, my kids ain't allowed to do music. That shit don't pay for real.
Wow. This nigga's insane. Yo, alright, so next record, man, we gonna rate. This is one of our favorites, man, on Dogs. This is my guy, Body Rock. He dropped 7,000 zings.
Feng Shui!
This is 9 tracks, 19 minutes. What you think, bro?
My nigga got the illest case of Tourette's, you heard? He be like, his ad-libs be like, say all dogs. All dogs, nigga!
Yo, this nigga's intro to the album was crazy because he's like, you know what? I don't be giving a fuck about this mixtape shit. And I woke up this morning and I said, I need 7,000 zings, nigga. 7,000 zings.
Yeah.
Fuck it. This is the album.
And I believe it.
Hey, the funny thing is I was texting Bordy today, man. And, I was looking at track 6, Don't Let My IG Fool You.
Yo, son, that's like, my favorite
I was like, yo,
record.
Who you talking about, gang? He's like, yo, I'm going to talk to you when I see you, gang. He's like, yo. So somebody pissed him off. He's like, well, put it like this. Somebody pissed me off And that was the mood that I woke up in that day. And I made that record.
I understand that.
And I said, all right.
I understand that.
I like that.
Because when I go on IG, when I post on IG, it highlight reel, baby.
Yeah.
You know? It's the glitz and the glamour. You know what I'm saying? Like, you don't care for the raw shit.
Nah.
You know what I mean?
Nobody will know if I'm having a bad day.
Nah, I'm not posting that.
For what?
Nah.
That shit ain't sexy, nigga.
Nah, because I'm not having a bad day. According to you, nigga.
Right.
According to my biggest hater, nigga, I'm never having a bad day, nigga.
I'm happy.
In fact, nigga, I'm great.
Nigga just made a $50,000 mistake.
Yeah.
And he's like, nope,
not I.
Not me.
Not me, not in front of you, nigga.
Nigga, I am happy.
Fuck you. Set the filter on.
Look at my kids, nigga.
Put the filter on, nigga.
Look at my kids. They cute, right?
Dead dogs.
Nah, I love this man because this is the body rock that I love, man. The no features, just body doing body. Like, you know what I mean? Like, this is him. He had a few different producers on here. He had Tremendous on here. I'm not sure who else was on the production, but Zings on Reddit had me fucking crying, nigga. Zings on Reddit and Good For Me. Good For Me, I like. Good For Me was actually my favorite record because that's body. If you really know body, nigga, like, that's body, nigga. He's like, falling in love with yens that ain't good for me. That's body,
yo,
nigga.
Yo, body was talking good shit on this.
Yeah.
Shit.
Yeah. Yeah. Tesla Zing. And the last record, Everyone a Shooter.
Yeah.
Everyone a Shooter, right? All you niggas is clipped up. Everybody got it.
Let's see what happens.
Everybody. You see, this is the thing about shooters, right? It's like when you do all of that, right? And then people try you. Then you got to actually do it. And a lot of niggas ain't prepared for that. So I love records like this. You know what I mean? When you hear...
coming for a nigga like Body Rock,
right,
too.
Right. So it's like, stop it. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? Just stop it. Just stop it. Cut the fucking shit, nigga. Spider Monkeys.
There's bars on this shit.
This whole shit, bro, like top to bottom, pause. You know what I mean? Like, this
Who's
was
the producer?
I know Tremendous was one of them. This wasn't like a one producer album. I don't think so, man. Because I feel like there was different sounds on it. But I definitely heard him shout out Tremendous on this. If it was all Tremendous, I might be wrong. I'm not sure. But I like this a lot, man. And Body dropped something just before this too, and we missed it. But this just dropped, so here we are, man.
I'm missing them all.
That nigga dropped so much, bro. Like it's kind of hard to keep up. But I've never heard a Body Rock project that sounded like another Body Rock project, even with all the music.
Oh, yo, dropped. There was a joint he did on this shit. It sound like he did a son's name, the Puerto Rican kid from Philly.
I'll be out.
No, the older Meek Mill flow. Fuck, Peter Crack.
Oh,
yeah, he had a record on here. You know what record I'm talking about?
What record was that, man?
Damn, I'll pull it up right now.
Throw more cut.
But I'll tell you, like, only if you know hip hop, you would know that he was doing a Petey Crack flow. There's no...
LBL's from New Jersey. Why'd I say LBL? Anyway.
But the name of the song has nothing to do with Petey Crack. You know what I mean? But you could tell. Yeah, Throw More Cut.
Yeah.
Throw More Cut. Yeah. You could. So like that Petey Crack flow, I was like, oh, look at that. You know what I mean? Because Petey Crack really was like that. That Puerto Rican.
The ring.
Yeah. Yeah, I mean, like Benny Siegel took him, you know what I mean? So I understood it. So like when I seen he posted a picture of it, I seen that song, I was like, that song is dope.
Yo, and Body's just a character, man.
Yeah.
You gotta see Dog to like really appreciate his style.
Nah. It's definitely nothing that you could like be like, oh, I get him.
Yeah, right.
You gotta meet some.
Yeah, word. And that's why I truly believe he's a visual artist. People got to see him to, like, appreciate him, man.
Dead dogs.
So I want to see visuals, man. I want to see.
Say that what, shit.
You know what I mean? Like,
Dead Dogs. Whatever.
On Dead Dogs.
You got an ad lib. Like, yo, say that shit.
Dead Dogs. Out of 5 red cups, 7,000 zings.
Yeah.
My man Bodhi Rock, we gave this 4.4. Out of 5 red cups, man. Shout out my man Bodhi Rock. Shout out Feed the Family. Yeah. I know Feed the Family got something coming out soon, man. I can't wait to hear that, man. I'm excited for that. Stay tuned, niggas. Bodhi, my nigga, keep doing your thing. This nigga.
Excuse me.
What you want, man? This nigga on some drunk uncle shit right now.
I'm trying to get the top and the bottle off.
The top. Pause. And nigga, you want to take another shot?
We all trying to get the top off, nah?
You want to take another shot? We all take another shot. Hey, yo.
Oh, you want a shot?
Nigga, I got one.
Oh, you good?
This nigga. You drunk?
Are you gonna catch up? All right, let's do the introduction, man.
Let me catch up. I caught up.
All right, this week we got some prolific talent in the building. You know what I mean? Somebody who's been doing their thing for a minute in the city.
Dead Dogs.
Well respected, well connected. Mm-hmm. One of the motherfucking coolest motherfuckers I ever had the opportunity.
Don't scare the bitches, nigga.
Don't scare the bitches.
Who scares my mic ain't on, but who scares the bitches?
I'm saying like, that's the cause you so cool.
Yeah. Okay, we talking about Vintage Link in the building. What's up, baby? How you doing?
I'm chilling. What's up with you, man?
You chilling? You feeling good? You just mad cool, my nigga. Let's take this shot.
Let's take a shot.
You know I'm an old man. I can't be doing shit like that. Vintage Lee.
Yeah.
What's the word?
What's good, my guy? How you doing?
I'm good, man. I'm good. I'm glad you're here, man. It's been a long time coming.
Yeah, thank you for having me.
Yeah, I thought you didn't give a fuck about us.
You don't fuck with us.
That's what I really thought. I was like, damn, yo, she don't fuck with us.
That's bullshit. You already know that. First of all, I was here before.
Yeah.
And then I was here before.
Yeah.
So what you mean?
You have to scope it out, though.
But you wasn't like here, like on the couch. You know, across from us.
I sat right there.
Yeah, but that was
you. Yeah, you know, so you
know. That's different, though.
But I mean, I fuck with you, you know what I'm saying? And I still remember we had that conversation in the lot in Dudley, and you were like, yeah, we going to get in.
Yeah,
and I was
like,
yeah, I'm coming through.
Word. Well, we finally made that happen.
Exactly.
Right. So for the people who don't know who you are, man, let them know who you are, what you do, what you represent.
What's the word? My name is Vintage Lee. I'm from motherfucking Roxbury.
Uh-huh.
I'm a superstar, do everything. And what else do you ask me to answer?
Who you are, what you do, what you represent.
And what I represent.
Yeah.
Just being yourself, you feel me?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I like that, man.
Thank you.
Being yourself.
I like it too.
And I get that from your music. So I felt like I didn't have to meet you to know you.
For real?
When I heard your music.
Well, that's what's up.
Because you just you in your element.
That's dope.
Okay.
That's dope that you hear. That's why you said, huh? When I said like what I said earlier about her music. Okay. Because earlier about your music, I said that I felt like your personality is so like quiet and just chill. It don't match the vibe that I get from the music. I feel like you turn up with the music. Like it's like it's a different vibe to you. You know what I mean? When it comes to the music. So I feel like when I hear you, like, you know what I mean? We was talking about...
You go ahead. I want you to expand on that, but I also want to see... I also want to say, like, why I feel that way. But go ahead.
Okay. You want me to expand upon what you were just saying?
Yeah.
I mean, I guess I could get why you get that, you feel me? I'm not that calm. Even if you know me, you know I'm rowdy as fuck. I'm with the rat, you feel me? Like, but
she from Roxbury, nigga. Come on, nigga. Let's go.
Nigga, fucking nigga talk about. Nah, but you feel me? But if I'm just out and I'm just around niggas, chilling. I'm chilling, you feel me? I ain't gonna do too much.
If I don't know you like that, I'm gonna talk. What was she saying on that record? What was that record?
Which one?
If I don't know you like that, why would I talk a lot of some shit? Come on.
Yeah.
She don't know you like that, nigga.
I like it, dude. What the fuck? Let me like it, man. What the fuck?
Yeah, man. So that's pretty much that. You feel me?
So this is what I mean, right? So coming from an ex-artist perspective, people rap in the way that they think of themselves, right?
Okay.
And they come into this, you know, mold. It's like, even if you cool, calm, and collected on the outside, because, you know, a lot of people tell me that too. Yo, you're mad calm, and like, most of the time and shit. But like, if you really be around me, like, you know, I'm with the shit. Like, you know what I mean? Like, I don't really give a fuck about nothing.
Yeah, you're a clown. So,
right, yeah. I just say whatever, whenever I feel like it.
Exactly.
But, you know, it's like, yo, nigga, like, you gotta know how to compose yourself and things of that nature. But your music, it's like, there's no time for that. Yeah. Let's let it all out. We on wax. This is what we doing. Let's have fun with it.
Yeah.
And you truly have fun with the music. I can hear it.
Yeah.
You know, and like, I'm telling you, till this day, cat, cat, cat.
Get back.
My daughter loves that record.
For real?
Yo. Oh, I swear to God.
I like that one too.
Like, that was 2020, right?
I don't even know. Probably. Something like 2021, that. I think.
It might have been. But I think it was during around the COVID era. Right, we doing another one?
Oh, I mean, yeah, I'm like, I thought we
were going to do another one. Drink Champs, yeah, Drink Champs for real. What's up, nigga?
You caught the right one?
Yeah. Oh, what's up, man?
Let's go. But
what's up?
My daughter. My daughter loves that record. And there's not too many, like, Boston artists that, like, my daughter really flocks to.
Oh, that's what's up.
If I would say. Cheers, my nigga. If I would say this too, it's going to be Vintage Lee. And Trevor Holmes.
Cheers.
My nigga.
But you like to categorize your music as like rage music.
Who right? the fuck said
when
that?
When did I say that?
I heard that in an interview.
Did you?
Yeah, I never said you was that. In Atlanta.
I don't know. You'd have to pull that up.
Yeah, I'll pull it up.
Okay, yeah, pull it up.
I don't remember that. I've never seen that interview, so.
I watched it, but either way. So you categorize your music as rage.
I said that around, what interview was this? Like, was I around, like, was it with, like, I was interviewing with three different women?
Yeah.
Okay, now it's at the table?
Yeah.
Yeah?
Yeah.
You said that dumb shit?
Well, you know.
Right? So, like.
What the fuck?
Nah, because he said I was in the A, but, you know, I don't recall saying that specifically. You feel me?
I got you.
But. Maybe I did in a sense. I like to rage when I perform, you feel me? Like, I like to jump up and down. I'm like...
Because I don't hear rage with your shit.
That's what I meant by rage. I want to jump... Like, I like to get crazy, you feel me? Yeah, I want to jump in the crowd. I want to hang off shit, jump on this... Like, I want to do all that shit. That's what I mean. I don't give it, like...
It's just mad jiggy.
Yeah, but I'm still going to... Like, that's what I mean. I'm going to still jump the fuck up and down on... That's what I meant. I didn't mean, like...
I didn't mean all that, but you know, I didn't get that. I was like, I'm back a few, okay, I can see that.
You said that.
Why is that?
What was you on?
First of all, hold on. See, niggas is I said what I said, so, but niggas is misconstruing what I said in the context. You feel me?
I really want to shout out the fucking highlights for real, like 2K shit for real. Before we talk about anything, that 2K shit is bigger than anything because we never got to talk to you.
Yeah.
So, like, I play 2K. You know what I'm saying? So, like, to hear you on 2K.
That's fire.
Nigga.
And you from Roxbury for real?
Nigga.
Yeah. Shout out to you, man. Let's clap it up for that, man. That's dope.
Bro, we never got to do that. Yeah. We never got to do that. You don't understand how big that is.
That's a big deal. How did that happen?
Connections?
How that happened?
So long ago. That's old money.
Yo, PR, PR.
That's old money. I love that.
Like,
how did that happen? That's what I want to clap my nose for right there, nigga. How did that happen, nigga? Dead dog.
Nah,
fuck all that.
I think it was just some team shit, you feel me? Like, yeah, honestly, that's beautiful. Like, yeah.
That's dope. You got an ill team, man.
Thank you.
The fact that you can't even remember how it happened is excellent.
That's the perfect part. I salute you for real. I salute you for it because that shit is big. Like, thank you, thank that shit you. Is bigger than you ain't even yeah. like, it's whatever to you.
No, it's not whatever, bro.
I'm not shitting on that. I'm just saying, like the overall impact.
Yeah, nah.
How many calls you got about that?
A lot.
Niggas put the 2K on it like, hey, yo.
I mean, I got what you need. Yeah. What the fuck is up with my game system, nigga?
What year was that?
2018, right? 2018,
yeah. Okay.
Oh, 19, God, one damn. Of those times, yeah.
I smoke a lot of weed, huh?
I was on point with the 2K.
Y'all niggas are funny, man.
Did you grow up on 2K? Like, you was on,
you
know, main
you know what's crazy? I was NBA Live.
Yeah.
For wow. a minute, I fucked with the live. I like games
I'm
a lot.
Lie to you.
I was
I'm
live
lie
a lot. I didn't like the 2K. Like, really? I was on NBA like 06, but then, you know, when they stopped making this shit, I was like, damn, I gotta play 2K. So I kind of just stopped. But 2K is nice now. I've been fucking with it the past couple
like
years.
Since like 2K2, I was on the 2K.
Yeah, 2K3, when AI was on a couple of like.
You know why?
Years
it's just because on 2K, you feel me? You had to do the little thing with the joint. With the little joint stick.
Nah, it's because they was thinking.
With the analog stick, you was like,
they
nah,
was
fuck
thinking,
it.
They was thinking.
I just want to press a button,
yeah,
nigga.
Yeah.
Live was like, yo, special dunk or die.
Yeah. You go special dunk or die.
Yeah.
For no reason.
Yeah. Special dunk for the 3-point line, nigga. 3-point double leg. nigga. That's why Live got shut down.
Nah, I'm hip. I was heartbroken.
Shit was a scam.
Like NBA Jam, nigga. Like that though. We thought NBA Jam was basketball. But nah, like you, that shit right there for me made me look into Ventures League. Before I even started doing this podcast shit, I was like, I already knew who you were. And that shit right there, I feel like was for a lot of motherfuckers.
Yeah.
So I'm glad to hear that you got mad get back from that shit, as you should. That's dumb.
So you move with this elusive style, right? Like you kind of like in the shadows,
like
shit.
Fuck nigga.
You know what I mean? Like I do what I want, when I want, how I want, whenever I want, with whoever I want. And I like that, but it's like, where's the music?
Yeah,
you know what I mean?
4 like, years, you blank. Need for Speed is dope.
I like Need for Speed. That, great
you.
Record.
Thank
great
you.
Great record.
Thank you.
Great. Immaculate. Great appreciate video. It. Everything was top notch.
Thank you.
But not mad at that.
Thank you.
Shit. You know, go ahead, just as far as consistency them. Goes, mm-hmm. a whole project since 2020,
mm-hmm.
what's the story on that?
I think, personally, obviously, well, like the music was already done, you feel me? But I like to move a certain way. Like, I don't want to just put shit out and just put it out. So, with that being said, sometimes, you know, you might go into a situation, you might try to talk negotiations. That might take a month, 2 months, you feel me? That might fall out, and now you're doing it again. So, now before you know it, time's just passing, you're still creating shit. So, it just becomes like a learning lesson.
Mm.
But, now the music's done, new shit coming out. Very the fuck soon. Called Grease Pack.
Okay, Grease
it's that
Pack.
Grease. It's that fire shit. You feel me?
I like that.
Yeah, nigga, I'm gonna play for y'all before I leave too. But yeah, everything's really just all an experience.
Yeah.
But I feel where you coming from. So
you know, from a fan standpoint.
No, I definitely, and right. I get that, and I get that. So it's like I feel just probably like how the people who support me feel too. You feel me? Because sometimes, like, it's just all an experience. You feel me?
Let me ask you this, because it sounds like it's perfect timing. What uh-huh. don't you like about this shit?
About what?
With this whole hip-hop. The business part.
The business part? What don't I like about it?
Yeah, the most.
I'm like, why get all quiet? I feel like it got quiet in here.
It's been quiet.
Come on.
I know. But what don't I like about the music part? I don't know. It's just real, like, political type shit.
So let me ask you this. Did Young M.A. fuck it up for you?
What you mean?
Yo.
Did she take your shine? Did she hop in your lane?
Nah.
You know, no bullshit, I ain't gonna hold you. Young M.A. and you like have very similar like swags. I wouldn't say cadences,
mm-hmm.
but like as far as like the messages y'all push, Mm-hmm. You know, it's like misogynistic women. You know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? Like, do you feel like that was a grab of your attention?
No.
Nah, not at all. Have you ever gotten that correlation before? You and Young M.A.?
As in, I've got that correlation, but not as in, oh, do you think that she took away from you?
I'm trolling, obviously.
I know you trolling, you feel me? Because, nigga, we wasn't on camera, nigga. I was about to say something, but I'm looking at you like this.
I had to say some wild shit.
All right. I'm like, okay. No, I don't really think so, because we got different, like,
y'all got very different styles.
Very different styles. Like, we actually got the same birthday, so maybe we just like the same shit. I don't know. Maybe we just like the same or into the same shit, but we just into... We just got different styles, you feel me? So I don't very think
different.
So.
Yeah. Like, musically, very different.
Yeah.
Now, with when it comes to, like, you, like, how would you describe your style exactly?
Honestly, it's just whatever the fuck I'm feeling that day. I might want to go and vibe on some shit that's just, like, a vibe. Sounds like you riding by the beach in California, nigga. I might want to do some hard shit, like, ka-da-ka-ka. Mm. I might want to do some... I don't know. I like everything. So, it's really just what the fuck I'm feeling. Like, I want to make some different shit that I never even made before. Like, yeah. I just want to do everything, like...
You got to tell
master
me.
That.
How ka-da-ka-ka even happened, nigga? Like,
well, this nigga like, produced it. This nigga...
Okay. Shout out, bro. You know what I'm saying?
What's but now name? Jordan never died.
That
he
shit.
Produces a lot of my shit. He produces fire. A lot of my shit. Yeah, and fire artists.
Let me get a bag.
We were just cooking up like a normal day, and he put the beat on, and like
that 80% beat is fire.
80% of the shit we cook on, he'd be like, "Yo, I don't like it," and I'm like, "Nah, nigga, keep it playing." So this nigga was trying to skip past the beat. He only let me hear like the first 3 seconds. I said, "Nah, nigga, put the beat back on."
What the fuck you ain't like about that beat,
bro? He didn't like.
He
that.
Was over it, nigga.
Well, he didn't make it, right?
He was high.
He like, man, fuck this bitch.
I've been hearing this shit for too long.
As soon as I hear it, I was like, yeah. This
yeah,
is
I
the
think
one.
It wasn't even the whole shit, though. I think we like cooked up around that, finished the sounds, and then I just cooked up on the shit. So, but yeah, it's like, it's just really whatever I'm feeling type shit.
How would you rate drugs?
Drugs? Ooh, yeah. That's a fast switch up. Hey, yo. You going fast. Need yeah, to speed, that, my nigga, but that, which
that
drugs?
That segue was crazy.
You need I to mean, be specific on I which mean, drugs. I just,
I'm about to break it down.
Uh-huh.
Wow.
I'm like,
how this nigga.
Can I talk about all drugs and everything?
How would we rate?
Yo, show me is collecting a bag here, man. What's up? Collecting a bag in the building.
So what drug are you trying to talk about, you said?
All drugs.
You got to be specific.
Because with me, I feel like with music, I feel like a lot of niggas come in like with a lot of inspiration from drugs. And mm-hmm. they shy to expand on that. They're like, yo, I'm
is weed a drug? Are we going to say weed is a drug?
Yeah.
Okay.
I don't even think, well, for me, it's not about the drugs. I don't need the drugs to make music. You feel me? Me, personally. Obviously, I like to be. Honestly, these days, I might not even want to be super drunk or high when I'm recording, you feel me? Like, I got the fucking headphones on. I just feel like the fucking shit's blasting my ear. Like, you feel me? I don't even want all that. For me, it's not about the music. Like, I made my first song that I dropped called Right Now. I was in the living room, and I was like, yo, God, if you want me to do this, just give me a fucking sign. I went on YouTube. I found a beat. Made the shit. Hit up Charlie. We went to a studio, like, 3 days later. I made the shit. And I was like, all right, cool. This one's I wasn't high or nothing. I was just...
So recently, or are you talking about the first song
the
you ever
very
made?
First song I ever put out. Not so ever Shirley made,
been
but to put out.
Rocking with you since the beginning.
Yeah.
I like that.
That's all.
Yeah.
All right, that's dope, man. And that was when? Like, when was that? What year was that?
That was like probably a year, maybe or two before I even put out my first song, so.
Wow.
Yeah.
That's dope.
Man, that's crazy. You, and then here we are.
Yeah, ever since.
Yep.
Damn.
Do you ever feel like you because you're not dropping as consistent as a lot of other people, bro. Do you feel like that dims like your shine essentially, like out here at least?
Nah.
I don't think she gives a fuck.
Everything happens at the time it's supposed to happen, you feel me? So in terms of dimming my shine.
But that's what I mean about elusive. So like you're like this. You're like a fucking
mysterious shit. You're like a fucking.
You gotta understand, bro. It's like you said. How do I feel about the industry? It's like sometimes shit is gonna go left. Mm. Sometimes shit ain't gonna work out the way you want it to work out. Sometimes you might think a situation is going to go a certain way, but it don't go that way. You feel me? Mm. And like I said, I'm about bigger and better. So if I'm going to do some shit, I want to be better than the last time. I want the situation to be better than the last time. I want shit set up. So you got to pick which end you want to. I might lose on that. I'm waiting a little longer, but my situation that I'm doing it might be a little better. You feel me? Sometimes that might happen.
Right.
And you got to deal with that. And I'm not the type of person, like you said, I'm not running to the internet like, oh my God, this, that, that. Right, nigga, you're never going to know because I'm not doing that. That's not me. Right. So that elusive part, you feel, if that was me, I'd be like, oh, bah, 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 bah,
bah, bah. But fuck
you,
nigga.
Yeah, I'm not doing that.
Oh, you thought that nigga was ill? Fuck that. All right, met that nigga. He a bitch ass nigga.
Bro, I'm not doing all
you
that.
You know how many
bro.
Fucking conversations I have with niggas like that? Be like, yo, niggas be telling me about industry. I'm like, yo, bro, I mean, I don't really know what you want me to do about that or want me to say about
yeah,
it.
Yeah, like, I'm but, not going to do all that. You feel me? Like,
the question's not, it's not about industry, nigga. Bro. It's about you individually, bro. It's all about you. It's not nothing to do about anybody else. Strictly about you. It has nothing to do about anybody else. I can't land this shit, right?
This nigga just had a Joe Biden moment.
I can't.
I really did.
I cannot, nigga. I can't. Disclaimer, I'm about to just smoke my
cigarette.
I'm about to smoke my cigarette.
When I think about your music, I don't think about other niggas. I don't think about...
Who was talking about other niggas, Brody?
Yeah. Nah, like, you think...
I'm never talking about other niggas.
Nah, y'all niggas talking about what other niggas...
No, I was talking about in comparison to people who are dropping. But you weren't paying
attention. I don't care about that.
Yeah, I don't care about that.
She don't care about that.
Yeah, clearly. And that's fine. And you don't have to.
Well, no, it's not that I don't care. I don't want you to think I don't care.
No. And that's
like,
fine.
You feel me? If it was up to me or like, you feel me? Like, I don't know. I'm just like the person, like I said, I want stuff a certain way. That's all. You feel me? So, but I don't not care. You feel me? I be getting mad, annoyed. But like I said, I'm not going to, you wouldn't know. I'm not going to go to the general. I'm not going to go online and say X, Y, Z. That's crazy to me. I don't do that.
That's real.
You think everything is about going online?
That's what people
do
these
days. Nah,
he's
saying it's elusive.
That's what people do these days. But when I say elusive, I don't even mean about, like, you being seen or anything like that. I just mean by, like just the way you move where it's, like, you march to the beat of your own drum. You know what I'm saying? And I think that people who actually really support you for real, like, that's all that matters. You know what I mean? Like, what was, like, the most inspiring moment for you when you realize like how many people you was actually touching?
I don't know if I know like a most inspiring moment, but it's just always fire to be like, oh, okay, like people fuck with you, you know? Like,
what's the most random place that you realize people were supporting you at?
The most random place?
Yeah. Because I know you got international followers. Like people who like really fuck with you.
Oh yeah,
of the
like a lot of spots in Africa, Brazil, Africa. Shit like that. Niggas are sending videos, chatting with me. I'm chatting back because I'm like, really? Okay, cool. Yeah, they talk to me about the weed out there. I'm like, y'all ain't got no good weed. They're like, yeah, we got gas. I'm like, nigga, you think you got gas? You're probably smoking like PK or some shit. Worse than PK, nigga. Niggas are smoking grass, but I'm like, okay, you got that grass. I'm like, you got that grease. Okay, send them more. Dogs, yeah, so
Kabe, nigga, they smoking that Kabe out there.
Damn, so Lee, you've been living off the rap for a long time. What can you give niggas back, like who are trying to do what you do, trying to live off of rap? Like, what first advice you can give them to jumping off the porch for that? Because I feel like it's a different game. I feel like a lot of niggas is out here doing a lot of different shit, thinking like, yo, I'm a real nigga, why can't I rap? I feel like rappers got it easier than me. I mean, I feel like rappers got it harder. I'm trying to eat off of music. I feel like it's crazy.
Yeah, I think maybe, well, first just keep cooking up, you feel me? Just keep cooking up, find your sound. And then after that, yeah, just keep cooking up. And well, me personally, all I did was I hit up all the blogs at the time before I put the first song out. I hit up all the blogs that was there at the time in the city. I hit them all up. I found them all. I emailed them the song. Yo, I'm trying to drop this day. If you could support me, let me know. If they don't hit you back, follow up again. Boom. Get a connection within the city or what's going on right now. Like, it might not be blogs right now. Maybe it's Instagram pages or something, Twitter. I don't know. But just find those pages. Send them your shit. Like, yo, I'm blah, blah, blah. Fuck with me. Boom. And then just find, like, a team kind of, or people who believe in you, and just go from there type shit. Mm-hmm. And just keep cooking. And then from there, the shit will just happen.
You posted some shit on Instagram today. Nigga. What the fuck was that about?
She needed a 3-5. I don't know. Like,
did you oblige?
I don't know. Would you do some shit like that?
I don't know. Oh, you ain't see the post?
Nah.
Oh, nigga.
Hold on. Show you, nigga. Why you gotta show me all that?
I'm gonna pull it up and I'm gonna tell you, nigga. Like, look. So I gotta read it because this shit's great. Man, so man. She gets a text.
Yeah.
That says, "Hey." Yeah, gotta do the voice. Hold up.
Hey, bitch.
Hey. Hey. I wanted to know if I could get a 3-5 possibly by tonight. My friend sent me your page. LOL. Do you take head as a payment?
That was the first option.
I don't really got it on me right now.
That was the first option. Head?
I don't really got it on me right now, and I'm out.
This is all in the same message.
No, bro. Listen.
This is all in the same message.
She don't reply. And then she goes, hello.
That's to the head part.
Hello.
I didn't know about that.
Hello is crazy.
I didn't know. The hello is like, yo, bitch, that shit works. Like, my head is on my stomach. My shit not. I never got the hello.
Yo, son, like, you know
the hello is crazy. The hello is like, bitch, have you heard?
Hello? Are you there? Did you see what I wrote?
You know who's asking to give you?
I was serious.
Brainless.
This is brainless brain.
I'm fucking weed, bitch. With a loose mind.
These niggas is crying.
Oh my god. So, how did that situation end up?
Well, no.
That was
a screenshot curious. That I seen on the internet.
Oh. Okay.
Yeah, but.
We know how we would have responded.
So you would have took the head for the 3-5?
Prove it.
Hey, yo.
What the fuck is you talking about? Let me see what you got.
What you gonna do, check my inventory, nigga?
You want the shit?
Oh, shit.
Nah, that's crazy.
Wow. That was excellent.
You served that up.
That was good.
Funny. That was funny, yeah.
So you just sold on in there and you just ran with it?
Well, it was just, it went with the song, you know?
Yeah, okay.
Yeah.
It was something about the internet.
Huh?
It was something about
the internet. Yeah, but I mean, like, why she posted that? Like, I thought it was real life.
Oh, nah, yeah, that would have been crazy, yeah.
I thought it was real life. I was like, wow.
Yeah, no, yeah, that would have been peculiar, yeah.
Peculiar is a great word. I want you to use that word in your next song that you write. Peculiar. Yeah,
peculiar. Fucking awesome.
What rhymes with peculiar, nigga?
Okay, you started.
Oh, shit. Man. So what's next for you, man? Like, you got the joint dropping soon. You got a date?
Grease Pack coming up very soon. Right. Yes, sir. And then I got Grease Feast. That's a weed-infused dinner. I had the first one at the start of the year.
Okay.
That's a weed-infused dinner, 3 courses. Okay. And then right after is the Grease Feast, like the function portion.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, niggas just come through, vibe. We got weed vendors, free weed-infused drinks.
Dope.
all types of shit. You just come, you vibe, smoke, get high.
You got dates for those?
That will be sometime in July.
Okay.
And yeah, DJs, popping DJs.
You a summertime baby?
Nah, April.
April.
Yes, sir.
Okay, but
Aries gang.
You seem like a summertime person. You come alive in the summertime.
You know, I'm not too big on the heat. Like, no? You feel me? Like, nah. Mm-mm.
No, that's why you wear Tim's right now in May.
Nigga, it's cold outside and it was raining today. What the fuck are you talking about? What you
it's
got
almost,
what
do
you
have on your July
feet? What you got? What you got on your feet?
Yeezys.
All right. Well, like I said, it was raining. I got socks on too, nigga. It was raining and it's cold.
Socks. Y'all niggas with shoes with no socks? Why y'all say socks like that?
That's, I'm just saying, like, no, like, these feel like socks.
Do you have socks on?
Of course I got socks. Okay. What is wrong with y'all?
That's freaky. Niggas who don't wear socks is freaky.
Y'all screamed out socks.
Nah, because they feel like socks. I got socks on. What's wrong with you niggas, man? Mm.
This nigga, it seems like July. You got your knees all out.
Who, me?
Yeah.
Yeah,
I'm comfortable. Yeah, I'm comfortable.
That's what's up.
This man was wearing shorts last week.
Yeah, that's what's up. I was going to wear shorts this week.
Nah, it didn't call for that.
Yeah, but my legs is ready.
Your legs is ready? Oh, you're spicy.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, okay.
He's one of them Diddy alumni.
Diddy party. I'll pick up the drugs.
Oh, speaking of drugs, y'all heard about the roofies in Boston.
Niggas is wasting drugs?
Yeah. Yo, speaking to the mic, man. Like, what are you doing, man?
Look how the mic looks.
Why is the mic like this? This nigga is drunk.
This nigga can't keep up with the Donnie.
What's up with you, man? You good? You feeling all right? Where you at? Where are you?
Where we at?
We in the garage, nigga. This nigga
cooked. I thought you could go shot for shot.
Wow.
What happened? Yo. You're gone, my nigga. I'm good. That's the crazy part.
Yo, fuck this nigga. Come on.
Yeah, I'm waiting on y'all. Right? Yeah, wait on
come
y'all.
Come on. This nigga's tapped out.
Yeah, you don't need no more.
Don't you give me. I'm an adult.
Are you?
I know where my limits. I know my limits, sir. I'm an adult. I know when I have to drive.
Okay. Mm. That's what's up.
Interesting.
Yeah.
Where we at?
No, but seriously.
Yeah.
The roofies in the city.
Yeah.
You heard about that shit?
You got roofies?
I ain't got roofies. Do you know anybody or have, like, you know, that you heard about whatever with shit like that in the city?
You know, I don't really know. I mean, my mans had told me one time he went out, he had one drink and he was fucked up. And you know, I went out and I had this one drink and I was fucked up. So. Mm.
What bar was that?
Maybe.
I would like to go there.
You want to go there?
How did you feel?
You want to get roofied?
I'm just trying to see what that feel like.
Yeah.
You know, sometimes you want to take your body to a limit.
Okay. I like that too, but there's different ways about that. It's a challenge. Yeah.
I just walk away from the bar like, hey, my drink is unattended. I'm going to the bathroom.
Mm-hmm.
I'll be back though.
Yeah.
Right? And then come back like, oh, I hope nobody fuck with my drink.
You know what I mean? So what you gonna do if you wake up and you just...
I mean, look.
You out, bud, right?
We try not to think about it that way, nigga. Come on, man. Like, we ain't going that route. I'm just trying to have a good night. No Diddy. You know what I'm saying?
That's fucking hilarious.
No Puff. All right?
That was crazy. You said the...
That's a tough... So that's swallow.
You said butt rape?
Yeah. I mean, bro, that would be what happened.
He did say that.
That's... If you pass out from getting roofied.
Oh, man. I mean, a shorty could have got him. Like, why he got to get...
That'd be dope. But that's not the person who put the pill in your fucking drink. The nigga who put your pill in your drink is
Yo,
level
my thing
five.
Is just more like, how can I drive home wavy? You know what I mean? Like,
I feel like I've done worse than roofies. That's what I'm saying. I feel like I've been...
But we was also much younger when we did that, right? So, like, you know, I'm 34. I'll be 35 this
year. So you're saying, like, one drink...
I don't know if I can come back from that, you know what I mean, at this point.
So you just want to get one. I know a guy.
I know a guy is crazy.
I know a guy is crazy. I don't know a guy.
Hey.
I don't know no guy.
Hey. 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 Whoa.
Your man's about to text you like, nigga, I can't serve you no more.
That's fucking wreck.
Yo,
look, that's not some shit you want, dude. I think Molly is the most extreme drug I feel like I've ever done. And coke.
You ever done Molly?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, but I feel like coke is...
You done coke too? Why do people always pause for that question?
Yeah, I don't know. Right? I've done coke. I've done cocaine, right? Yeah. And I feel like cocaine is a small part of Molly. Mm-hmm. Like, I've done Molly, and I'm be like, wow, like... This shit is shit on cocaine. Like, what? Like, give me all this shit every time. I gotta put this shit in a drink. I gotta hurt my nose. All that shit. This is beautiful. This is
remember Molly water? We was doing that shit.
Molly is a way better drug than terrible. Cocaine. What niggas?
Disgusting.
Yo, for you niggas that's chasing coke, yo, you ain't got to hurt your nose, bro. Go ahead and do Molly, bro.
Hey, yo.
Yo, for real. Yo, Lee, let's save him, Lee. Let's save him, right?
Save the nostrils, guys. Save your nostrils.
Honestly, because like...
Don't do drugs, actually.
Because coke is going to hit you like mad.
I never did coke, so
yeah, don't do drugs.
Know.
Yeah.
Never did coke?
Nah.
You're missing out on the best part of life.
You know, bro.
But look, here's what I say. Like, with coke, like, it just hyper-extend. Like, it just boosts everything.
That's what I feel like Molly
does. You don't need that.
What?
I feel like Molly just makes whatever you're feeling at the time 100 times that.
Mm.
Right? That's how I felt when I was on Molly.
Now, imagine that 10 times for coke.
So you feel... That's crazy. But you feel like... All right, so imagine. Remember the first time we did Molly?
Yeah, I know.
So I felt like spending money. So now I'm in the club forcing it.
Now, all right. But look... Like, how long did that last?
I feel like I blinked and it was over.
Well, either way, it lasted for like a couple hours.
Yeah, it did.
Right? Coke is gonna last 10 minutes.
Oh, shit.
It's going to feel like 10 times that in 10 minutes. So for that, I'm not with it. I can't fuck with coke.
That's an expensive habit.
Yeah, coke is crazy. It's like. Nah. I can't fuck with it. Molly? Molly was a good time.
Yeah, Molly was a good time.
Molly was a good
time.
That
was a good summer.
Molly was a good time.
That was a good summer.
Yeah, but weed ain't shit compared to that.
But they have different effects.
Weed is like kind of like lean, right?
Do you feel like you made any records like off the drugs that like your most, like what's your most creative record you made off the drugs?
I really just be recording off weed and tequila.
Okay.
Used to be Hennessy.
Wow. Real black shit.
Hennessy is a damn.
Yeah.
Hennessy don't make you violent?
Henny black. Yeah, that's why I don't drink the Henny no more. Yeah, you just turn into a whole different animal, you know. Like, I don't want to be that guy no more.
I don't know. I don't know. And it is only Hennessy because Deuce don't have that same effect on me.
But it's not just Hennessy. It's not Hennessy. It's not just Hennessy.
What, champagne?
We drink Paul Masson.
We drink Paul Masson. Don't say we drink Paul Masson.
We drink.
Yeah, okay, because I'm like, we don't drink that shit no more.
Yeah, but remember when we drank Paul Masson?
Yeah, but that shit didn't make me
brandy,
violent.
Right?
It was brandy. That shit didn't make me violent. It was Hennessy.
No?
E&J made me violent.
That was like the same shit.
Y'all niggas was sipping E&J.
We old.
You
niggas.
Never drank E&J?
I didn't say I never drank it. I said y'all niggas was sipping it.
We was old. Yeah, we was young niggas at the time.
Oh, okay. Yeah. It was cheap.
Yeah, it was cheap. I mean,
it came in a glass bottle.
Guess me the bottle.
It was cheap and it came in a glass bottle.
Yeah.
That was his understanding of it.
If it came in a glass bottle, it was respectable.
Right. But anything you came up here to talk about, yo? Anything you wanted to get off your chest? Come on, get it off.
Fuck niggas.
I don't got nothing on my chest, nigga. Nigga, nah. You know, like, unless niggas got shit to say to me, you know, I don't got nothing on my chest, nigga.
You feel like niggas have something to say to you?
Nah, that's what I'm saying. Unless, you know, I don't
mean us. I mean, like, niggas.
I know you.
Nah, I guess.
I mean, like, you know what I mean? Niggas be on some shit. Niggas be trying you, nigga. Niggas be trying you.
I mean, you feel me?
For real?
I would hope not, nigga. Cause I mean, I'm sitting right here, baby. Clearly.
Hey, you think women? You think women run Boston hip hop?
I mean, we definitely on a run right now. So that's. You feel me? I say that.
You think y'all still on that run?
What? Well, here's the thing. See, I'm not into the. Before we get into all that, like, I'm not into all the.
You mean what, nigga? What?
Nate speaks.
Okay, she's a woman.
She's like, the fuck. I give it to her, and she's
so running. So because of her, women are running rap in Boston. Lee,
Oompa,
bro,
you sure don't give it to the women, sure?
Right now,
I'm asking you.
Right now, no, I don't. Right now,
I don't
now,
give a fuck about that.
In 2024,
I don't care. See, y'all niggas,
asking,
y'all niggas is doing a different
nigga.
Argument
not,
that
I'm
I don't
not even,
asking.
I'm asking this nigga. You're not giving it to him right now. Key.
Okay.
You're not giving it to him?
No.
Okay. I just want to ask. Now,
when you think about the ecosystem in Boston, if you want to put it in that term, then yeah, you might have an argument there, but I feel like there's a lot of niggas who's doing a lot of shit on a national level, like low key, that are not getting they just do within the city with certain, you know, groups that women are allowed in that these street niggas.
Wow, you saying because they niggas?
No, because they street niggas.
Oh, okay.
Not because they niggas. Because there's a lot of niggas around that.
Yeah. All right.
But you know, they are part of a certain community.
Okay.
Well, right. You know, I just do with that too. You feel me? I had a show that he wasn't trying to let niggas have it. You feel me? I had all street niggas on that shit. I do my just do.
That's
so
hard.
Yes, I do. I do my just do. You feel me?
And that's respect because I feel like within the female community out here in Boston, it's a lot of, you know, women, like straight women plus LGBTQ plus, right? Mm-hmm. And it's like they clicked up because they felt like, oh, street niggas don't fuck with us. But you fuck with the street niggas. So you, I feel like you are the, you and Oompa are like the exception to that.
Yeah.
Because y'all do it all.
Yeah, I mean, I fuck with everybody, you feel me? Like this whole, like you feel me, this whole thing where you're like, oh, the females. The niggas, no, I'm saying like the whole thing where you're like, oh, the females are doing this, the niggas are doing that. I don't buy into that whole thing. I just buy into the whole, what a rapper's doing. I don't give a fuck if you got coochie, dick, in between. I don't care. I'm just, I don't care. But like, but your point is valid. But I fuck with everybody, you feel me? So I think if you're doing something that I like, I fuck with you. Like,
and that's dope, and that's what it should be.
Yeah, I didn't know that there was certain people don't fuck with
but
these
women,
people. I didn't
like
know
female,
that.
Like women, female rap, I don't know.
Yeah, I didn't know that. Yeah, whatever you want to say.
I don't want to be politically incorrect.
Say what you want to say. I'm just letting you know. Right. I don't,
women
I
rappers
don't
have
that.
Told me, whether it be on the platform or off the platform, like, well, niggas didn't accept us, mm-hmm. even though we're not gay women, mm-hmm. but we flock to the LGBTQ crowd because they accepted everybody.
Okay.
And I hated that narrative because I'm like, why didn't the men accept y'all? Did they not think you were dope? Like, did they not like your music or whatever the case mm-hmm. may be? Like, you know what I mean? And the conversation was whatever, right? But mm-hmm. all I'm saying is at one point, I want to say 2020, maybe 2021, yeah, women had it on Smash, on Dead Dogs. Like, mm-hmm. without a fucking doubt. There was no debating that.
Yeah.
But I would say right now.
Yeah, right now.
Yeah. And I don't think that really matters at mm-hmm. the same time, but I'm just saying.
Just for the sake of
the
conversation.
No to that conversation. Like,
yeah. No. Okay.
Like, but they're all dope female artists out here, period. That's like, real. A lot of them.
That's you know real. I mean?
Like, and it doesn't really matter whether you're male or female. Like, if your music's hot, nigga, I'm going to fuck with it. I like music. You know what I mean? Like, you see what the fuck we play at the beginning of this fucking episode, man. Like, we talking about old shit. I love old shit. I love new shit. I love weird shit. Whatever. However niggas want classified. I listen to all types of shit, nigga. I pulled up to a bar the other day, nigga, playing fucking Blink 182. You know what I'm saying? The fuck? All the small things, nigga. You see what I'm saying? Are you alive? You dead?
All the small things.
What's up with you?
That's my shit. What are you talking about?
You just look like you was, I don't know, man. Like, you all right?
I'm fine.
Nigga going through it.
That was a good song.
Yeah, yeah, I know. I know.
You pulled up playing a good song. What do you want from me? All
right.
If you pulled up playing R. Kelly, what you want, nigga?
You still listen to R. Kelly?
Yeah.
Me too.
He got two records I really, really, really will never stop bumping.
Just two records?
What two records?
No, I'm saying the two that I fuck with. That I won't stop bumping. I mean, I can't get behind a nigga pissing on little girls and doing all this extra shit. What do you mean? Whoa, it's proven. We're not even gonna get into that.
Yeah, don't do that. We're not. No, stop.
We're not gonna debate.
We're not debating what happened.
So you're telling me you're okay with a nigga pissing on a little girl? Oh, because you said,
okay.
Whoa.
It's not okay. What I'm saying is, like, the music is separate from that.
Is it?
He a boondog ass nigga. He's like, yeah, if you don't want to get peed on, move.
You said you got daughters?
Because Diddy is.
Nigga, what? I see what you want, nigga. You the type of nigga we talk about A and you going to talk about B.
Cash,
I see what you want.
Stop it. For the sake of the music.
Who said anything about Diddy though? We talk about R. Kelly. Why are you trying to switch? Why are you trying to move the goalpost? Yeah, let's stick to what we stick it to though.
Let's talk to Robert.
Yeah.
All right, so you talk about Robert Kelly.
I just told you.
Two songs.
What are the two songs? What are the two songs?
Where's the one he's like, so let me my D E before I get knee deep. It's the remix. Oh, I don't see nothing wrong. Oh, Bump and Grind remix.
Bump and Grind remix. Okay, okay. Right.
That's my jump off.
Okay.
And what's the other one? Bump and Grind.
Okay.
Them two is my joints.
I get it.
Bump and Grind's
a
classic.
Yeah.
My mind's telling me no. Yeah,
I get it. R. Kelly, at your age,
she's 28. She's not going. R. Kelly gave so much to music.
No, I fuck with all of R. Kelly. I'm not
R. Kelly
that.
For the in general for like of music, like in
yeah. We only talking about the music,
just the music.
We don't know that man.
Just in music.
I would never.
That's the music. Chocolate Factory was on repeat.
Musical genius.
He was pissing on little girls.
Wow.
Yeah.
And had little girls pulling up to the crib.
I get that part.
And was fucking all the little girls.
Wow.
And enslaving them.
Nah, wow. For sure. Absolutely.
And yeah. I mean, that's what matters.
Yeah.
But the music was dope.
The music was good.
That's the fucked up argument, right?
The music was good, but.
That's the argument. That's the argument. It is.
Yeah.
It is because the argument is that the music is still good.
The music is great, but he was still. You said you got daughters, right?
Well, yeah, I agree.
But you know, he's pissing on little girls. He's fucking little girls. He's enslaving
them.
Little girls.
Yeah,
he's marrying little girls.
But there's only music. The only music that gets magnified for that scope is hip hop.
And he ain't hip hop.
Speaking to the mic, man. You speaking past it.
What you mean he's not hip hop? R. Kelly's not hip hop?
I mean, nigga, he sings. I mean, he's obviously in the hip hop realm, but.
R. Kelly wrote and produced with hip hop.
I understand that. No, I understand that. When I talk about what he wrote and produced, I'm talking about what he put out. You know what I mean?
As an artist.
Yeah. As an artist. R&B. Yeah, that's it. Producing is artistic.
But you talk about his output.
Yeah, that's his output.
I know, but we're talking about his vocals. Shit, he puts vocals on.
So you don't think R. Kelly put any output?
See, I didn't say that, but here you go, moving the goalpost, nigga. You see, you can't do that to me, nigga. I see what you're doing, but listen,
he violated for sure. But mad niggas violated, right? And they're gonna continue to violate, right? So P Diddy is the same.
See, here you go talking about P Diddy. You feel
me? Same thing, because like we played Diddy earlier, right? And I think about it like this: it's like we never gonna escape this battle, bro. It's like, yo, bro, like, they gonna magnify exactly what happens, and like, you can have.
You know
somebody...
why we never gonna escape the battle?
Yo, I have people close to me who violate, who I will expose, and I expose every day. But niggas will expose a billionaire who they don't even fucking know the sake of what.
And they still close to you?
Nah, hell nah.
Oh, okay.
Nah, I mean, for the sake of what? The sake of nigga, you a weirdo, nigga. Like,
yeah, but not
like the fuck is you talking
but
about?
Not
like,
exposing, but not exposing the close ones. That's
oh, nah, you gotta expose everybody. Like, if you a weirdo, you a weirdo,
that's
nigga.
What I'm saying, like,
you gonna
niggas,
die on that sword.
I'm
nigga.
Just
that's
like, niggas is jumping to fucking expose Diddy, but you got niggas close to you who man. That shit is bothering me. That shit bothers me.
Puff,
that shit bothers
Puff,
me.
Puff is gonna, he's gonna get what he deserves. But either way, when we look at the grand scope of things, right? R. Kelly, the impact he had on music, we can't take that away from him. The nigga's fucking weird,
he's
though.
Sicko,
he's a sick
bro.
Motherfucker,
he's a
bro.
Sick motherfucker, bro. And he deserves to die, bro.
The nigga,
he's gonna
the nigga,
be at the he's gonna be at the premiere of Summer Jam,
the
bro.
Nigga Kendrick
in hell.
On that shit. Your son is a sick man with sick thoughts. I think niggas like him should die.
Yeah, right? I want all them niggas to die, bro. I want all them niggas to die.
So yeah,
all them niggas to die.
Yeah,
but it just sucks because it's like.
Cause you like his music.
You like the music.
You be in the song. This the yeah. This,
yeah.
This,
like you know what I mean? Like right, you yeah. Listen. I hear Diddy. I hear Bad Boy. Every time I hear Bad Boy now, like
yeah.
That shit makes me sick.
Yeah, when you hear Bad Boy come out and play now, you're
like, yeah,
like what the
damn.
Fuck do you mean by that, my
yeah,
nigga?
Like, you know,
yeah,
you know
like what the fuck is that?
You
yeah.
Sick.
So what am I? I have to separate them, Lee. I have to. That's the only way I get to survive.
So how do you put them in a category?
Yeah,
is it
like
Sean?
That's how you...
Is it Sean Combs, the businessman, versus Puff Daddy? The fact
or what is
Puff
it to you?
Is
do you not listen to
like Puff Daddy is crazy. Now that we think about it, why is that his name?
Puff Daddy.
Puff Daddy.
Is crazy.
Why is that his name?
Whoa,
who gave him that?
What the
Puff Daddy?
Oh my God. Oh my God.
Yo,
Lee, so do you get like that's my question for real.
What's the question?
Like, do you separate the music from the person?
I mean, it depends. But like I said, he's pissing on little girls and enslaving little girls, fucking little girls. I mean, well, I don't know what you want me to
you
do.
You can't support
what
that.
You want me to do
nah,
with that
shit
like, I can't,
that shit
I
you can't
know,
go
like,
with. That shit.
Yeah,
can't
like
go.
I don't know, like yeah. There's a line that has
there's
to be
no,
drawn.
There's no debating that. I don't know what I'm asking at that point. honestly, there's no debating that. There's no bit. Nah, for real.
Yeah.
I don't know what I'm asking.
That's fine. That's okay.
I just think like it's a constant battle with the music and shit that happens, and we the only musical genre that it happens to. Unfortunately, I feel like.
Do you feel like you would ever suffer some shit like that? Like, if you like,
well, that's
if
crazy.
If you, whatever, what?
Not no pedophilia
oh,
and weird
sorry.
Shit. I'm talking about like mistaking, like separating the music from the artist, right?
Do I feel like I would ever
like say you like
did something
went viral because you whooped somebody's ass, nigga, yeah, like, type shit. Like, do you feel like your fans would ever have to like feel like, yo, is she a good person? She whooped that bitch ass and
like, would
on
you
her.
Take to that? Like, would you like gravitate to that if they're like, damn, yo, Lee is whooping ass? Like, you know what I mean? Like, she whooping ass. Like, you know what I mean? You'd be like, yeah, I'm whooping ass.
Nah, but like.
Like, I seen it on camera. She bent
I mean?
Over and
like,
pissed on her.
Yeah, like, yeah.
It was a rap.
Yeah. I can see it. I can see it. You sold
yeah,
it. I can buy it.
Wild as fuck.
I can buy it.
I can't.
You are. I can see you being violent.
I saw Tim Prince all over that bitch.
Yo. Now I'm like, I don't even know what the question was because y'all niggas is crazy.
Do you feel like your fans would ever try to separate the two?
I mean, you don't got to separate the two unless it's some wild shit. I mean, you don't have to like pissing on little kids. That's
whoa, whoa,
some wild
whoa.
Shit.
I'm
that
talking about pissing on grown
crazy,
adults.
Crazy, yo.
Because they violated.
Crazy,
oh,
son
me?
Really did so that.
Like, oh,
I pissed on a nigga after whooping his ass before.
Oh, okay. That's what's up.
Nah, y'all never did
that. I mean, that's really shit. Speaking of, I'll be right back. I use bathroom.
Y'all ain't never did that. No, you ain't never done that, cat. No.
Now you had time to piss on a nigga?
Yeah, he's knocked out.
I see a nigga knocked out, but I never had time to piss on a nigga, like whip my dick out.
It's wild. You gotta be in a different state of mind. Like you really upset. I was in the, you know.
I'm always fearful that I would shoot a nigga, bro.
I don't want to shoot nobody, but that's the ultimate disrespect is pissing on a nigga's knocked out body.
Yeah, but I kicked the nigga in the head, and after I kicked him in the head, I wanted to shoot him in the head.
I ain't want to shoot nobody that. Like, you shouldn't be saying this.
No, we're going to edit
crazy.
This out.
It's kind of crazy. Like, why would you?
We're going to edit this out.
Yeah, yeah, we're going to edit this out for sure. God damn.
I'm just saying, but like, that was my next reaction. My next, after kicking a nigga in the head, I was like, I want this nigga dead.
Why? You already won.
Yeah, but I kicked him in the head. He was knocked out. I kicked him in the head. In my mind, I thought he was dead.
Right. So let's make sure.
This nigga's crazy. I'm crazy for that.
Nigga, yes. If you thought he was dead, why are you overkilling it?
To confirm, chick.
You think if a vulture thinks somebody's dead, they're gonna like not try
vulture,
to eat him?
A vulture's not gonna eat if it's not dead.
But that's what I mean. You think if they gonna not try to eat? That's what I'm saying.
I'm trying to.
It's an instinct. It's an instinctual shit. Like, it's like, all right, he dead. It's grubbing time. They not gonna realize you're not dead until they trying to grub.
Yeah.
If you thought he was dead, leave him alone.
Oh,
that's what I'm saying.
I get what you mean. I'm not a vulture.
Like, the fuck? Yeah, it's like myself. What is else gonna say? It's not that boy gonna say. I think I'm the boy. I'm being basketball. This nigga, man. All right, Vintage Lee.
I need a little bathroom.
My nigga.
Nah, it's cool. You know, it happens to all of us, man. We're going to take this last shot, man, and we're going to close it out. We're going to get some red cups and rap, right? Some balls?
Let's do it.
All right, let's do it, man.
Ooh, yeah.
This shot is to Vintage Lee, all your endeavors.
Proceed.
Everything you got going on, we in your corner, man. You know that.
Yeah,
niggas.
Yes,
But this was fun. Red Cups and Rap Time. This is CWTFB Radio. I am Charlie Machine alongside my drunk ass right here, man.
I'm drunk. Cash, you got me. Y'all got me. Sense. Y'all got me. I'm drunk.
We have Vintage Lee in the building. Make some noise. Yeah. Vintage Lee, let's go. Grease pack on the way.
Don't scare the hoes, nigga.
Yeah, scare the hoes. Don't scare the
Don't scare
Grease pack on the way.
And we love y'all, man. We in the Garage Media Center at the Sound Lab, soundlabma.com. Let's get it, man. We out of here. Let's go.
Yeah.